I am part of an organization on Rutgers called the Are You Healthy Dining Team, and it is a student organization that's a joint program between dining services and the nutrition department that is basically trying to promote nutrition on campus. We're comprised of a faculty advisor and 8 student nutritionists, and we conduct boots every 3 weeks on different nutritional topics where we're trying to have student interaction by learning nutrition.
In addition to weekly newsletters we distribute in the dining halls, and we also have interactive nutrition education booths. During these booths, we pick a specific topic that we feel pertain to students, specifically in the dining halls, and we conduct various research studies and collect data on their responses. In this particular study, we tested student awareness and education of antioxidants and omega-3 fatty acids, and we focused on where they get their information from.
And we conducted this study at 4 campus dining halls where we asked students to volunteer to play a nutrition education game, and we also gave them information and a newsletter on antioxidants and omega-3 fatty acids. In addition, we gave them a survey to fill out, questions asking where they get their information from, if they knew of the health benefits and food sources of omega-3 fatty acids and antioxidants.
After all the booths were executed, we compiled the results and analyzed them using a software program called SPSS, which basically shows the trends of the results. And we learned that a large number of students were being misinformed about the health benefits of antioxidants and omega-3 fatty acids. And we had discovered that they were receiving this information through word of mouth or the internet, which are not exactly reputable sources.
The internet is a fine source of information if it's from sources such as .gov, .edu, or .org, and these are all reputable sources. Unfortunately, these sources are not necessarily the most easy to navigate or would be the first sources to come up on a Google site. So often students rely on .com sources, and they are not reputable and do not always have accurate information.
The results of this study showed that 37% of the students were aware of the health benefits of antioxidants, whereas only 18% of the students were aware of the health benefits of omega-3 fatty acids.
This study shows that programs that are university-sponsored, such as RUTV and also the RU Healthy Dining Team, really have an impact on student information and education. These venues should be utilized to their full potential.
Our faculty advisor is Peggy Policastro, MSRD. She is the school dietitian, and she is also a professor of several nutrition courses.
Professor Policastro was really instrumental in helping us polish our research, not only the methods of how we ask the questions and what sort of questions to ask, but how to analyze the data. So the students did the work, but we were really guided and mentored by our advisor.
Conducting research has taught me how to correctly and accurately do research, what appropriate questions to ask students, the process of becoming IRB certified. And it's a very valuable resource to have. As dietitians, there's always research to be done, as nutrition is an ever-expanding field.
Conducting research as an undergraduate student is really beneficial. You still have the guidance of a faculty member or a graduate student, but it gives you the flexibility and the opportunity to really explore how to conduct research and implement how your research affects other people.